What's good, y'all? It's your boy Ross back at again with another video. So we're gonna check out saddest WrestleMania moments that made the fans cry by none other than Tap Out Corner. There's been some emotionally sad moments in WrestleMania history. I think the one most noticeable one, or the one I can easily think of off the top of my head, and I think a lot of us can, was Ric Flair's retirement match. And I have to put quotations there because I believe he's having one more match. But Ric Flair's retirement match was against HBK. It was such a beautiful moment. That match was so fantastic. It was beautifully set up, beautifully paced. When he finally lost, the crowd was showing love. He was tearing up. Shawn Michaels damn near was tearing up. It was great. The I love you before the super kick was fantastic. Beautiful. It was like an emotionally sad moment because just a lot of us was thinking, well, this is it. He's not wrestling no more. Boy, was we wrong. So we're going to check this out. Appreciate all the love and support. Let's get into this video, man.
After a roughly 3-month hiatus, Ric Flair returned to WWE in November 2007 to say he would never retire. However, Vince McMahon had other plans. McMahon said that the next match Flair lost would result in the Nature Boy being forced into retirement. The next few months were filled with heart-pounding moments as Flair did everything he needed to do in order to avoid retirement. Mm-hmm. However, in a crazy move, Ric Flair actually challenged Shawn Michaels to a match at WrestleMania. HBK was hesitant, but Flair insisted that he wanted to fight Shawn. At WrestleMania 24, the two legends laced up their boots and went toe-to-toe. Michaels and Flair
fought
a phenomenal match that only they could do. The fans watched intensely the entire time and held on to every moment. Finally, Michaels had a chance to hit Sweet Chin Music, but was second-guessing himself. Ric Flair saw this and told HBK to bring it. This led to Michaels' famous line.
He did say I love you. I know, I could have sworn he said it.
Mr. WrestleMania hit his finisher and pinned the Nature Boy, ending the career of Ric Flair. The emotions began pouring out immediately after
that. This was a beautiful moment.
Once he got up, Flair was in tears, as well as many others. While the Nature Boy had wrestled again outside of WWE, it was still sad seeing a legend's career come to an end. Ironically, 2 years later, Shawn Michaels would find himself in a very similar position as Ric Flair. At WrestleMania 25, Michaels earned the opportunity.
Easily one of the greatest matches, one of the greatest WrestleMania matches of all time. I still get goosebumps just talking about this match. One of the greatest WrestleMania matches ever.
Opportunity to face off against one of his old rivals, The Undertaker. The dead man had never been defeated on the grandest stage of them all, and HBK would do anything to be the first man to do it. Mm-hmm. Shawn survived some brutal punishment, and at one point, fans thought Michaels might do the impossible. However, in the end, Mr. WrestleMania had his shoulders covered and became another victim of the dead man. Afterward, the Heartbreak Kid became obsessed and won one more match with The Undertaker. After scratching and clawing, Shawn Michaels got his rematch with the stipulation that if he lost, he would retire. With everything on the line, Shawn Michaels...
And this was a good match, too. 26?
The Undertaker again WrestleMania 26.
That match at 26.
HBK gave it 110%, but despite his valiant effort, Michaels could not get the job done and suffered a second defeat at the hands of the dead man. Just like that, the career of one of the most legendary wrestlers came...
Even though he came back many years later, which I really wish he would have stayed retired, but... Nevertheless, this was a very emotionally charged moment.
To an end, and plenty of tears were shed because of it. It seemed like the odds were always stacked against Daniel Bryan.
The American Dragon
defeated John Cena and won the WWE Championship at SummerSlam. However, the moment was ruined when he was attacked by Triple H. This allowed Randy Orton to cash in his Money in the Bank contract and take the title from Bryan. Daniel would try to become champion again, but he'd always get screwed by the Authority. Finally, after fans invaded the ring on live TV and refused to leave, Triple H agreed to fight Daniel Bryan at WrestleMania 30. If Daniel won, he'd get to compete for the WWE Championship in the main event.
One of the greatest
Bryan pulled off a massive victory in
main
event. Triple H. The game wasn't playing.
Very good main event.
He attacked Daniel after the match, forcing him to go into the championship match injured. Despite all the odds stacked against him, Daniel Bryan overcame all of it.
Yep.
The American Dragon hit the running knee.
Beautiful
and
moment.
Made Batista tap out. After a long...
Michael Cole's commentary on there, this was good. This was... His commentary on there was fantastic. Tap out Batista, tap out Batista, tap out Batista. Dog, stop. The Miracle on Bourbon Street, bruh. Michael Cole's commentary, we don't give it enough credit in this particular moment, was fantastic.
Hard-fought battle. Bryan had finally become WWE World Heavyweight Champion again. The fans celebrated loudly, and cheers of yes, yes, yes rained throughout the stadium. The underdog had prevailed. This one is...
I wouldn't have called it the saddest moments then. Saddest WrestleMania. That's not a sad moment. It would make you emotional. The first two definitely were sad because, you know, we was going to miss some of our favorite wrestlers. This one, he won. So I wouldn't have called this a sad moment. It definitely would make the fans cry in a positive way. So I probably would change the title like WrestleMania Moments That Make the Fans Cry, not the saddest. You know what I'm saying?
It's sad for all the wrong reasons.
Oh, now this was, yeah, this was definitely sad for the wrong reasons.
When Booker T made his WWE debut in 2001, it was an uphill battle. Being that he was part of WCW, the company that tried to put WWE out of business, Booker wasn't welcomed with open arms. After putting in hard work, Booker T won a huge opportunity, a World Heavyweight Championship match at WrestleMania. The champion, Triple H, made this rivalry very personal.
Yeah.
He said,
"Somebody like you doesn't get to be a world champion."
Yeah.
Triple H made other very personal attacks on Booker in the lead up to WrestleMania.
With the racial overtones.
The match
overtones.
Should have been a heartwarming moment with Booker winning, but instead, Triple H beat Booker T and retained his championship. It was such a sad moment in WrestleMania history, and not in a good way at all. For two decades.
Yeah, I mean, you know, you gotta let the past go, but that one will never sit right with me. They definitely dropped the ball on that.
One of the traditions of WrestleMania was The Undertaker and his streak.
This was a sad moment.
At the event, and every year, a new opponent would try and defeat the Phenom. Every year, though, Undertaker always had his hand raised. At WrestleMania 30 in 2014, Taker was going up against one of his toughest opponents yet, Brock Lesnar. The Beast used his most powerful move, the F5, but, as everyone expected, Undertaker kicked out.
Yep.
Brock hit a second F5, and Undertaker kicked out again. Brock hit a third F5, and Undertaker
didn't kick out.
In complete disbelief, the streak had come to an end.
No one could believe it.
Couldn't believe what they had just seen.
I couldn't believe it.
People thought would never happen. And honestly, a lot didn't want to ever see it.
To be honest, I don't think The Undertaker should have lost the streak. The only time, I'm telling you this, the only time The Undertaker should have lost was to put Roman over. Now, hear me out. Put Roman over as the heel. Brock didn't need this to be guaranteed a championship, to be honest with you. Brock didn't need this, to be honest. Yes, make the match at WrestleMania, but you could still have The Undertaker win it, per se, if you want to. Roman, if the Roman situation still wasn't getting over, at this time we didn't know it was too soon, but it... If anything, the only time he should have lost was to put Roman Reigns over as the new guy and people would have hated him. That's the only time I would have been somewhat okay with it. You don't have someone take the streak unless you're going to put them over and the only person that you could ever put over would be Roman to make him the most hated guy, the top heel. That's the only situation that I could ever see that working. Other than that, I probably would have never done it. And even then, with the Roman situation, that's an iffy one. So, I don't know.
However, Lesnar had
this was a shocking moment.
A legacy that took 20 years to build. Kurt Angle is easily one of the greatest wrestlers of all time.
Oh, for sure.
When he announced that he'd be retiring at WrestleMania 35, it was sad news. What made it even worse was when it was announced that Baron Corbin would be Angle's final opponent. Fans did not want to see Corbin be the last person the Olympic gold medalist fought. Regardless, the two squared off at WrestleMania in a match that wasn't awful, but nowhere near worthy of being Angle's last match. It ended with Baron Corbin getting the victory as well, which made the entire thing a major disappointment. Fans were sad to see Kurt Angle retire, and that he went out on such a terrible
note. Yeah, that was not good.
Not fitting of a legend like Angle.
Nah, he deserves so much better.
One of the most iconic couples in WWE history was Macho Man Randy Savage and Miss Elizabeth. That's why it broke fans' hearts to see them break up in 1989. They remained separated for nearly 2 years, and in that time, Savage got into a rivalry with the Ultimate Warrior. This led to a retirement match at WrestleMania 7. Unfortunately, Macho Man lost, which meant his in-ring career was over. While that was sad, the real tearjerker came afterward. Sherry Martel, who was the Macho Man's manager, was upset that she couldn't smooch off Savage anymore and started attacking Randy. Miss Elizabeth, yep, who was watching in the crowd, couldn't bear to see it and jumped into the ring and saved Macho Man. With Sherry out of there, Elizabeth and Macho looked at each other and embraced in the ring. The fans cried,
look at that, bro. Randy Savage. And that's back in time where people were believing what they saw in the reel was legit, not a storyline.
And Miss Elizabeth finally back together. Even though he lost his wrestling career, Savage won something much more valuable.
Yeah.
These are the WrestleMania moments WWE wants you to see. But there are...
Oh, man. This was a good video. Like I said, I probably would have changed the name to... maybe WrestleMania moments that made the fans cry, because the Daniel Bryan one wasn't sad. That was probably one of the better WrestleMania endings we've had in quite some time. It was so good. The fans got what they wanted, and that's all you can really ask for. You know, the fans truly got what they wanted. They weren't even supposed to get that. We weren't supposed to get what we got, and we did. So comment down below. Let me know, man. What's the saddest WrestleMania moment you can think of? If it was in this video, let me know. If it wasn't in this video, let me know. For me, it has to be, I want to say, it was probably the Undertaker ending Shawn Michaels' career the first time. I mean, when he actually retired. That was pretty sad, only because it was like, damn, man, you thought he was going to get the job done, but he finally hung it up. And he did not wrestle for a very long time, so I will give him that. WWE had been trying to reach out to him to get one more match, but he never really signed up until much later on, which I really wish he didn't. But that was, for me, when I was watching it, it was very heartfelt. It was a very sad moment because you could feel like, damn, this is it. I'm never going to see him in a wrestling ring again. It was crazy. So, but... appreciate all love and support. Road 2, 90K. Appreciate Dark Kicking with me. See y'all next one. Peace.